welcome to another episode here on the Minecraft Let's Play Season 2. I'm standing here in the sort of middle of my base, almost a little bit further out. We have the middle over there where we can see the sheep farm in the background. I also are beside the turtle farm today. But what we are going to do is actually something that I have been craving a little bit. I am in need of XP, and mostly what I gotten it from to this day is from trading with villagers and also mining out a lot of ores and then smelting the ores and getting XP from the ovens and also from getting the ores. That's why I have this massive field of copper blocks here that I am waiting for them to turn into this oxidized stage. Some of them haven't changed at all, some of them have changed more, but yeah. So that's the XP sort of place, or not placement, what's the word? Gathering process that I've worked so far, but it's not that efficient and not that great if you want to just get XP. So instead, I've been down here. It's where I've been down mining for that XP, so yeah, or those copper blocks. And it's a very large cave system down here that actually reaches down further into one more thing that are the main sort of source for my XP, and that has been this mine shaft, which is big. It's very, very enormous, I think. I have gone on a lot of different, gone on a lot of different routes, gotten lost a couple of times, had to dig myself up just to get out of here instead of trying to get myself back. But what I also found down here is actually not one, but two cave spider spawners, and they are very, as you can see, in close proximity to each other, and this is just a sort of optimal spawning spots for having these guys to get XP from. They are not that efficient. For example, a zombie spawner or a skeleton spawner or even regular spiders would have been a little bit better, because these are very hard to hard to work with. Cave spiders are a lot smaller than regular spiders, so they can fit inside of one block space, so this block here, and also half a slab. So if I put a slab on top of here on the upper side of the block, for example, here, then this space here they can fit through. So it's a lot harder to work with them. They are of course also poisonous, and that's also a very hazardous. That's why I've lit up this part around here so much that I can, so nothing can spawn here. And yeah. Except for that, of course, we need to make this a very regular XP farm, I think. We have to dig out, when you have just one, you dig out four in each direction, because these spawn spiders in a 9x9 area, both upwards and downwards and sides and so forth. So we're going to have to start by digging out this place to actually get these two spawners in optimal condition for a collection area first, and then it's just going to be the regular spawner thing that you have to gather them up in one spot, kill them with, for example, my sword here, which I have looting on, so we hopefully will get a lot of string as well, because I'm going to need some string in the future, so it's much better, and also of course get those XP things. And hopefully until we get a better XP type of farm, this is going to be the best we have. So I'm going to start by digging out this area, get a feel for how large of space we need and how to make this work, since we need to be in close proximity to these spawners to get them to activate, but also keep away so they can sort of keep a steady flow of spiders. So I'm going to start that. We're going to cut away in a short break, and we'll see each other once I actually have dug out this place a little bit more. So, welcome back from that short break. A lot of stuff has happened. I did get carried away a little bit and have done a lot of stuff inside of here. So, just to update you on what's happened is that I've dug out this area where I need to get the spiders working. I heard something. What was that? That sounded like a zombie that got turned into a drowned, but yeah, maybe there's some water around here that I'm not aware of, or something. Yeah, nothing here at least. Okay, so back to the explanation. So what I did was that I, as I said, dug out a 4x4 around each of the spawners. You can see here where my markers have gone because I have for this spawner I put in this deep slate, now I don't even remember, deep slate bricks that went in a formation around here. So that's the to that block and around there where the spawner should be able to spawn spiders. For this block here, or the spawner here, we have the diorite blocks, which are polished diorite and not something else, but I have a texture pack on that turns them into brick format instead because I find it to look a little bit better than the regular polished diorite. So, yeah, we have those, and you can see that I have gone a little bit further out from each of these points. And the reason for that is because then I did get a rectangle for shaped room instead of having one square there. And then have blocks on these three parts here, where we would have then gone here, and it would have not been very easy to make it with the water down here. So that's why I have expanded the room a little bit bigger than it needs to be, because it's not going to affect us or anything. It's just going to be a little bit bigger, take a little bit bigger space, but nothing else, just to make the water work. And after that, once I've dug everything out and we needed to have two blocks above, three blocks below, I had to look that up when I was digging, and it was not four as I remember it. It was just four around, not up and below. The water after that, I did turn water sources here at the side, and then got the simple, as I call it, stair technique, where you take water as far as it can go and then just take away it so it flows down. The one th problem that I did get though was that the water that come from here, from these two blocks I think, did go here and ran straight into this wall instead of flowing down into this place. And that could have gotten some of the spiders stuck or something, or they wanted to maybe climb the walls or something, because that's what spiders can do. So instead, I decided to put in two water sources, one in the corner and one over there, so everything can flow, and of course, the same on the other side. And then we have one more staircase to go down here, where I've started digging out to make the killing chamber slash collection area where we need to kill the spiders to get that XP. So I'm going to start off with that now and show you guys what I plan to do. And then we're going to talk about some of the other stuff that I have in the inventory as of now. So we need to start by putting in these water blocks, and then I have to think a little bit about what I want to do. And I think that we need to do it this way. So I need to go down to some more blocks. We're going to put in a double chest over here, and then we're going to put in hoppers. No, not there. Done wrong the first thing we do. Have to cut this out. This is the part that I haven't really done yet, so I don't know what to do really. We need to have the hoppers there, but I need to stand there. So yeah, going to start by putting in these hoppers, and then yeah, because now I'm going to get down below, so to put in some blocks once some more, and then take away these, and take that so it goes into those, and or that one, and then we put a chest over there instead. Yes, now it works. Have to think a little bit about how we do this stuff and where to put everything. And yeah, I just now no, this should work maybe. I'm thinking that we maybe should have put these hoppers here instead, so that we would have been a little bit closer to the water, but I think that it should work. A little bit afraid of the spiders turning here, but the water should push those out. So yeah, now then, to get the thing to work and have the spiders not kill us on first space, and yeah, that was the wrong side. We should put slabs here. There, so yeah, we did really get it right. So we have spiders coming there, and then we need to put, yeah, no, I have done it wrong. Oh, nothing goes right today, it seems. Take this away. So yeah, we need to get the hoppers into here instead. So there, and then chest first, chest there, and not singular chest, double chest. Then we put, no, not, oh, I'm not, it seems like I shouldn't be doing this today. So those two there and that there. Then we should get it right, because we have spiders that spawn, they get pushed in under the slabs here, but to prevent them from hitting myself, I have to put trapdoors here. Then we get similar to the turtle farm, we get a space that's placed here, so cave spiders are just a half a block tall, but now they can't get through here, and I just have to keep a little bit distance so I don't get poisoned. Now then, what about this big hole here, you're maybe asking, and the reason for that is because I want to try out a new block. This is called tinted glass, and it has a very nifty ability. Even though you can see that it is glass, we can see through it, it doesn't let any light through, so it's going to be completely dark on the inside here. Now we have lit up with torches and so forth, so it's not going to be completely dark. But these are going to make mob farms very, very much nicer to build, because we can get windows inside of farms where we can look into and see what's problems, or just get the satisfaction of actually watching the farm in pace when we need dark spaces. How you get them is by taking regular glass, and then inside of a 9x9 grid you put the amethyst shards in four spots, above, below, and on the left and right side. So yeah, it gets four shards and you get two glass, so it's a little bit different recipe than we are used to. Usually you get the same amount back that you put in, or something like that, or in some recipes you just get one block out of the, for example, four you put in, or something like that, I think, at least if I remember correctly. But yeah, tinted glass, I've stand up in one of the geodes where we have gotten these and getting the amethysts to grow, and then I just harvest it as a block for that. So I'm just going to start by placing these, and I'm going to have to place some torches on the ground here so we don't get mobs to spawn here. Even though we are on the Mushroom Island, I don't want to keep have anything that could adventure this, so just to keep it safe, we're going to lift it up. You can see here that the ground turns very dark because the light sources from there don't get through to the glass. So we could do that, and we're going to take these blocks away because they are not necessary as of now. And then we're going to make a wall here as well because I want to look inside this and also to get the chance to use this glass actually. Once I've now stood in here and gotten everything to work, I really want to get the farm going and yeah. So yeah, now we have not forget that that upper part up there, and to, or we can have that, no, or maybe not. Yeah, we should take that away, I think, because I don't know if something will spawn up there. There, and then we have also a very nifty ability. I don't have any. I have the silk touch here, but if I remember correctly, and I'm actually going to try it out now, is that I'm going to use this block, and I'm not going to use silk touch, and it still drops the block. And we can see now that the spiders have started spawning because it's a little bit dark down there where I put out the torches. But we can also see that the mini cave spider here can't get to me by hitting. I did get a little bit closer now, and then I get poisoned. But if I just stand back here and hit that guy, we can get the XP. Then we just have to do it this way. So yeah, now we're going to do the very, very fun part of going into that. Take down the blocks, and we're also going to put in some slabs on top of the spawners and take away the torches and everything that you need to do that to maintain this. So taking away a couple of blocks here to keep me, and then we're going to go down here, and I'm going to start by taking away this blocks first because they are the most hazardous, and then I'm going to need to go up, I think, or maybe we should. Yeah, we don't have anything. Yeah, take away all the things on the walls, and then we go up. Then I'm just going to go out and go and take away this one. We're going to put that there. And then take away the torches around. And hopefully don't get killed in the meantime. So there. Then we take that and hurry up by taking away these blocks. And then we need. I should have taken that one first, I realize now. But yeah, we're just going to brave it. Do I have anything to build with? Yes, we have some deep slate blocks here. I just need to get that torch. Now it's completely dark here, and we risk spiders to spawn on my bridge, so we should be a little bit faster, I think. Yeah, there we have it. And then get these blocks back in place here, and also putting in, yeah, we can take some granite here, and then for the last part, I'm actually going to take some tinted glass. A little bit of overuse, but then we can look inside of here, and even though it's not very, very dark. Completely dark, we can see a little bit, but we see also the amount of spiders. This is good. I think it has with the mob cap to do because I don't know if this affects it, but we don't have a lot of mobs inside of here since we are underneath the. Yeah, I'm just going to lower our hostiles here. So yeah, we are down under the Mushroom Island still, so we are getting a lot of things here. And I should have probably upgraded my sword a little bit, and the spiders are walking out, but they are going to come down, and I think this is going to work very, very nicely. Just have to be a little bit quick so I can get that XP. It's going to get stuck there, but I can't do much about it. I could maybe have put carpets on top of the hoppers because that's what you usually do, but then we couldn't have the slabs there because that would have occupied the same block. So yeah, this is going to work very, very nicely. I believe at least. It's very effective. And yeah, I do have a lot of stuff here as well. But yeah, there we have the spiders, and even though the XP is the most important part, we also get some string and some spider rice, which I can use later on. And yeah, I should not. Now I'm just going to take precautions and put some lights inside of here. And get out of this place and eat something before I die. This is, as I said, the bad part about this thing. But yeah, this is working, as you can see. We have a lot of spiders down there. So yeah, and even though we can see their red eyes in the corners and on top, they are going to, at some point, their AI is going to go, and they are going to go down there and get killed. So yeah, I'm just going to take a little bit further away so we don't get interrupted a lot by the spiders. They are a bit noisy. But oh yeah, there. Where should we be? We're in a tight space. But yeah, I hope that you have enjoyed this episode. If you did, consider subscribing so you don't miss future episodes. I'm going to do a lot more farms, more advanced than the regular ones that I've done today. If you don't subscribe, you can also leave a like and a comment instead and tell me about it that way, and I would really appreciate it. We'll see each other in the next episode. Goodbye.